long-awaited update to Doki Doki Takeover, and by God, what did Duster do? I'm getting ahead of myself. Let us start from the top. DDTO Plus is the final send-off to this long-developed love letter to all things DDLC and FNF. This Act 3 aftermath takes us on a visual novel journey that will change the Doki girls forever, but maybe not for the better. People had high hopes for this mod, wanting to see this peak go even higher. So today, I will be breaking this mod down, discussing its main aspects, and seeing how good it truly is. If you enjoy this content and want to see more, please leave a like and subscribe. I am not going to go over the content from DDTO. You could check out that analysis to hear my statements and in-depth thoughts. For this video, I will quickly go through all of the major changes between the original and Plus. First and foremost, they got rid of the lower difficulties. Is it really that hard to make lower difficulty charts? The prologue songs have been redone. High School Conflict is much more DDLC-based with its music, but does someone care to explain why Monica is a brunette now? She has gotten a lot more cheery with this new sprite, but that is not how she acts. Monica is fairly optimistic, but her expressions are more calm and collected. The original sprite did this better and generally looked more like Monica than the new sprite. The dialogue portraits make this more apparent. Her voice is now a pixelated version of her standard voice. But the original sound-based voice worked better with its music compared to the new one. Not a great start. Bara no Yume has enhanced its tension, with everyone sharing the same effect on their vocals. Monica's expressions have the same problem, now getting more out of character with the visible frustration. The two went straight to the fighting idol before the dialogue even started, quickly summing up this song's problems. Your Demise now has a Japanese aesthetic, so not only are the character stereotypes, but the music also plays on a stereotype. The angry expressions are still here, and worse with both the standard and the large sprite. The glitching looks worse, likely due to the smaller face. And Boyfriend's new idol conflicts with his poses and the dialogue that expressed his anger. The Markov notes are more abundant, and this chart has numerous errors. You had 8 charters, of which I would assume at least 2 of them worked on each song, and you still have these errors? You are not making a strong case. Your Reality is now played after Your Demise, which works with the dialogue. The song is now a remix, which makes use of Monica's new voice and works better with Senpai's voice. The only problem I see is Senpai singing motifs to his own songs. The focus of this song is DDLC, so Senpai's songs disrupt the flow. Better, but not a score changer. Inside DDLC, the clubroom has gotten a makeover. Sayori has a little more bounce, and her skirt moves more. Raincloud's fixed its charting error, so there is nothing bad to mention. My Confession has the same music, the same charting error, and it made the camera zoom for the sudden drop worse. Why did it change it? Natsuki's head no longer shakes in her down pose. I think this is worse, but it does not do much harm. My Sweets fixed the charting error I referred to, but then I found new ones that were not fixed. Baka also fixed its charting error. Yuri's hair has more animation. Deep Breaths kept itself from losing its perfect score. The dialogue to Obsession shows that they made the horror weaker. The song has Yuri smiling in her idol, but her poses are the same. The Markov notes are generally unchanged, and the devs spoiled their presence in the menu. They did fix the song's charting error, but the downsides balance with the upsides. Monica is basically the same, but this is a problem I will explain later. Reconciliation, like most of the original songs, had its note patterns altered. The ends of certain patterns now put emphasis on the down pose, which does not fit with the music. The art can support the song, but it can also hinder it. The festival got some better candles. Crucify is the same as My Sweets. It fixed an error, but then I found another that it did not. Beethoven did not need any adjustment, but the devs decided to remove notes that defined the vocals. They chose to create a charting error. It's Complicated did not change when it needed to. Glitcher had its vocals changed, not only including the new pixel voice, but also changing vocal patterns. Some change the sound and another alters the placement, yet the chart remains the same. You change the vocals, but not the chart. How does that happen? Bones and Thorns had Monica's sound-based voice replaced with the new one. But this song was not made with that voice in mind, so it does not work as well. Dual Demise does the same thing, but it also gave Monica new patterns that Boyfriend does not repeat. Most of the errors also remained. Epiphany got more detail and polish in its art. It removes some of the more problematic Markov notes, and they are also harder to hit. It is finally a difficult yet balanced challenge. Alongside this, there is a new version of the song where Monica sings lyrics to you. The problem here is that the music was not designed for lyrics, so they do not work well together. I will give them separate scores. Now we move on to the new content, starting with the encore chapter. In the music club, we see Monica have personal conversations with each of the other girls. Hot Air Balloon is Natsuki's song. She expresses to Monica that she feels concerned about losing her place in the club, which, by the way, is untrue. Although a bit forceful, Natsuki gets a spot in the club, and her struggle comes from learning to get along with the other girls. Falling into irrelevancy was never her concern. Back to DDTO, Monica tries to show Natsuki what makes her special. The music starts calm, but the vocals jump straight into it with no buildup. The composition is styled after Natsuki's DDLC music, being cutesy and bubbly. The voices work well with the music and have a great rhythm. It is a song that does not properly fit the context it was provided. Shrinking Violet is Yuri's song. She thanks Monica for the opportunity she created by making the club. It is not wrong, it is just generic. The song is overall calm and soothing, supported by the great vocals and excellent chart. As generic as the context is, it does not keep the song from being incredible. Joyride is Sayori's song. She feels more cheerful than ever and appreciates everything that has happened. Sayori then mentions that it has helped her combat her depression. No, Duster, you did not. You did not just force a sad moment into this story. Well, not only did he do that, but he also made Monica get emotional as a response. Let me get this done before I lose it. The song is upbeat and high energy, going against the forced sad moment. The music and vocals are celebratory, and there are rays of light to support this. With a great chart, the song is well made, but the context hurts it. Our Harmony is a song where all four of the girls sing together. Or at least, that was the intention. Sure, all four girls sing in the song, but it mostly consists of Monica alternating with each girl. The music is more harmonious, and the vocals are, again, celebratory. The music fades out and back in, but it gets old after the first one. The end of the song features Monica's voice actor singing lyrics as a custom CG defines the end result. This song had such a good idea, but the director did not enforce it. Sayori mentioned that she overheard Boyfriend singing with the MC. Are they doing fan service now? Why did they give the MC a personality? Neat is not the term that describes MC. That would be Hikikomori. His appearance is based on his unused concept art design, and his poses show his lack of interest. The song is low energy and partly somber, but that goes away once MC gets into his groove. The beginning of that shift is more emotional in the music and the art. There is a charting error, but the song is well crafted. You and Me is the send-off. Boyfriend and girlfriend have left, leaving the literature club to its own devices. MC reflects, in a positive light, what has changed because of those two. With an uplifting tune, the song looks towards the future, or more specifically, MC's future. Halfway through, you are asked to choose one of the four girls. Whichever one you choose will sing with MC for the rest of the song. Each girl brings their own verses, playing to each girl's music style. I feel that this song works better with Monica in comparison to the others. After some time, if you have not chosen one of the girls, you die. I get it, he died of heartbreak, but I feel that it would have been better simply to have something in place to pick one of the girls. Aside from a charting error, this song is incredible. After this song, Boyfriend and Girlfriend return to show the Literature Club a gateway into their own world, where they can explore to their heart's content. Monica gets emotional again, and the story is concluded. Takeover Medley is the final message from the mod. Composed by 6 people, this 6.5-minute song takes you through every character's chapter. The characters exist in windows, and a mouse cursor drops new characters into the opponent's window. The backgrounds are styled after the backgrounds found in the unlockable wallpapers from DDLC Plus. This song is celebratory and high energy, having a composition that works with the many different vocals and motifs. The chart has a great flow, but the lag is not so fun. The mod has a caching system that can preload characters and songs, but there are other elements that can and will lag without precaching. For the medley, you will constantly see these stickers in the corners. The stickers themselves are randomly selected, but it takes multiple playthroughs to stop the lag these cause. For the sake of the song, the presence of charting errors is the bigger problem. Titular is a Henry Stickmin song from Versus Imposter version 4. Unlike the other festival songs, this has no provided explanation for its relevance, but my best assumption is the comparison of characters influenced by player decisions. MC's voice is similar to Henry's voice, and the instrumental maintains the decision time vibe and mischief feeling. This mix adds a whole new section, but while it sounds great, there is not a reason for it. The one more is likely playing to the player decisions, but in this mod, the MC is a side character. The one more visual also has little relevance to DDLC. The concept is keeping it from a perfect score. With the final chapter completed, you get access to some extra story. Love and Funkin' features a girls-only club meeting. The Doki girls find it strange that girlfriend never sings given boyfriend's rap prowess, so they encourage her to write a song for him. This song is more romantic while still keeping the upbeat nature of DDTO's music. The vocal flow is calmer, making the watch then repeat verses define the song. When Yuri starts singing, girlfriend starts playing the poem game, featuring an assortment of words from the original game and some new ones to fit with the situation. The song serves its purpose given the concept. Catfight is a reference to the argument between Yuri and Natsuki. You get to choose which girl to play as, which is quite interesting. To keep things positive, the argument sprouts from the two trying to compliment the other while degrading themselves. The music is the equivalent of making a serious theme out of the song's name, and the vocals work well with this. The song takes reference from both arguments, the first one through Sayori trying to be the mediator, and the second one through having the song continuously speed up. Considering how much this mod likes to stay away from horror, it is surprising to see them reference Act 2 outside of the main story. This song repeats the same verses over and over again, made more challenging by the increasing tempo. Certain verses will also get more difficult as the song goes on. Another charting error later, and this song does well for itself. Constricted is an OC insert. When the girls return from the outside world, Natsuki and Yuri mention people they met. Sayori says that a friend followed her the whole way, even to the club. Just to show that Sayori is an idiot, she sees no problem in singing with Zipper. This tense song is a mix of a demonic and angelic feel. The vocals are alright, but hearing these two voices singing together feels forced. The song has a small visual effect. Otherwise, it is an uneventful song, which is the main issue with it. Wilted is the return of a familiar face. Through the conversations with Monica, Senpai has become self-aware, and he decides to work with the spirit to reunite with Monica. First off, Senpai is the spirit's vessel. It is the one speaking, not Senpai, but Duster did not write Senpai that way. If it was clear that the two were separate, this could be plausible. But given Senpai's attitude, this is not the case. Anyway, Senpai gets insistent on getting his way, so this song is more of a quarrel between the two. The high energy, pixel and non-pixel music and the great vocal flow make for a good blend between Senpai's music and DDLC. With another charting error, the song stands as alright. Libertina is the secret song, and it is quite a shocker. As I said earlier, this mod liked to stay away from horror, so much so that it does not even tell you that you unlocked a link to look at the bad ending. This song is the last thing you would have expected to see, based on the scraps of information that can be found from digging into the depths of DDLC, Libertina tells of a mysterious experiment. Everything here is either a reference to one of the elements related to this experiment or something hypothesized from it. This song tells the story of a person who was broken, tortured, and now forced to live a life of pain. After everything I have discussed, I am genuinely shocked with the quality of this song. However, there is a thorn. The ever-present charting error strikes again. I'm sorry. Hold on, we have a bit more to discuss. Drinks on Me is based on Valhalla, cyberpunk bartender action. You sing against Valhalla's bartender, Jill Stingray. This song is styled after that game, from the characters and their appearances to the white text that passes by. The music has a chill, techno feel that ramps up as the song goes on, and the voices harmonize with this. With a great chart, this is an incredible song, but why is it in this mod? This song should be in its own mod, not clumped together with a concept it does not work with. It would get a perfect score in its own mod, but not here. Now, Duster said he would have no joke songs, so clearly he wanted to bury this. Yeah, there is a chart for the epic rap battle between Goku and Superman. It is still in the files, but there is no way to access it in DDTO+. There are still a few small things I want to mention. Monica being unchanged makes for situations where her expressions do not work so well with the mood of the song. Her down pose is unfitting in every new song aside from Wilted, and that song makes the other poses unfitting. The main menu has some new faces. Dying as any of the Doki girls will get them thrown in the recycling bin, unless it is mirror mode, in which you play as the opponent. There is a mass number of unlockable outfits for the characters, and a good number of them are unlocked through mirror mode. I am not a fan of the hints. It takes away the fun of exploring. Indie Cross's achievements force you to figure it out on your own, but their names serve as clever hints. DDTO Plus sometimes spoils the surprise with the hint. The outfits look great, but there are just too many of them. Some of this time could have been put towards making the songs more immersive. Imagine if every song had the quality of Libitina. That is everything that I have to discuss. Here are my overall scores for the mod. When people praise FNF mods, they typically refer to the art and the soundtrack. Gameplay is often overlooked, and the writing is an afterthought. But it takes a balance of all these elements to make something incredible. Over a year in development, and Duster's writing ruined the wonderful image of the mod. At least for me. Feel free to share your thoughts on the mod in the comments below. Until next time.